you are not dizzy, you can see well. I think it's time to touch on a completely new way of farming gold, which is multiboxing. Although I personally am not at all familiar with multibox, reading your comments made me interested in researching whether it is possible to farm golds this way. But since I've never used the tools necessary for this kind of gameplay, it would be good to show the whole process of adjusting this kind of setup. So let's start. The tool required for this is called HotKeyNet. You have a link in the description of the video where you can download it. I found the link on the forum from Warmane, so it's not too hard to find it. If you can't download the latest version, you can also download the next latest one. Tried both versions and they work fine. After you download and run it, you need to have a script that enables you to multibox. It is a single file that you can edit in Notepad. We will build on the script through the video, step by step. In order to be able to test the tool and see how it all works, you need to have at least two games running. In my case, I have two WoW installations, one for the main character I control, which we will call Master in the rest of the video, and one installation for the other four characters, which we will call Slaves in the rest of the video. If you are wondering why two installations, more on that later in the video. Before starting HotKeyNet, it is still necessary to change the name of each WoW window so that the tool knows which window it must send commands to. To do this, you have to go to Action and rename window in the tool. After that, select the WoW window you want to rename and press the right click on your mouse. Change the name and press Enter. The names of your windows will be important for you to write in the script later. You can also change the name of the window automatically in the script, but we are just learning this whole process, so we will not complicate it. In my example, our WoW windows are named from WoW 1 to WoW 5. I made 5 druids that I plan to play on Onyxia. The reason for this is that a druid at level 68 gets a fly form that automatically teaches you riding skill up to 225. Therefore, we saved a lot of gold here. Another advantage of the druid is that it's a class that can be a tank, melee DPS, ranged DPS, and healer. Whether you want to play, druid can provide you. I'm sure there are better class compositions for multiboxing in the Burning Crusade, but again, we won't complicate things. Let's load up simple script, which got only buttons for movement and numbers 1 and 2. We can see that our slaves soon collapse and everyone is walking in its own path. So this simple control of your slaves won't work. The next thing you must do is create a macro for following and assisting. And in this macro, every slave will target the same target as master and follow the master. On each slave, I put this macro to activate when I press 1, and on master, I have empty slot on button 1. After that, you must bind interact with target to the hotkey so that the slave accounts can interact with master target. You can bind this to any desired hotkey. Just remember it to put it into script in HotKeyNet. Everything I show you now, you have to do for each slave account separately. I also binded almost all my left bottom and right bottom action bar, where I will put more spells once I get higher level. You can play without additional binds, but sooner or later you will run out of space for your abilities. Also, inside interface, turn on click to move on each slave account. For example, when I select some NPC on master and press keybind for interact with target, which is button T, if slave is too far off target, it runs to it. So we modify our simple script by adding letter T for interacting with our targets. And now remove our movement keys because our slaves will follow master with their macro on button 1. And we can see that now our whole multibox group walks together, they all can target same target, and on each window we can cast spell Wrath. Basic multibox setup done. What about questing? Next thing to do is to set up add-on Jamba, which is designed for easier multiboxing. I will show you two different settings. On the left side of the screen you see my settings for Master, and on the right side you can see my settings for Slave. That's why we run two different installations of WoW. So you have different settings for Master and different settings for each Slave. This add-on gives you super options that when you start a quest on Master, each Slave will start it as well. Same goes for completing quest. Here we use our keybind interact with target. Let's test accepting quests. On my Master, I come to quest giver. Press T for interact with target and accept quest. We can see that all of our slaves got it too. Once we complete quest, come back to the NPC, T for interact with target, and boom, all slaves completed it too. By now, you are probably annoyed with quest tracker in the middle. Quest tracker and this bar can be moved with holding Alt and left click. And you can see that with few keybinds and pretty much simple script, we can multibox. As you will level up, you will get more spells, so you will adjust your keybinds and your script along that way. Before I proceed with additional things, which can be implemented into script, a big thanks to Wesscer, another Warmane player who helped me with several things with my multiboxing experience. He sent me his super script, which I turned into several basic ones. You can find his Discord server along with YouTube channel in the description of the video. Thank you, man, you helped me a lot. Now we are adding additional things to our script. First thing we could use is automatic renaming of our windows. Add whatever key you want. In my case, I use Control with F12. Another useful thing is to automatically position your windows, so you don't need to do it manually each time. Adding also that to a script. In my case, I use Control with F11. And then add every single hotkey combination which you plan to use. Every single letter, combinations with Shift plus number and Control plus number, so later we just add spell on every single slave account along with Master. Wesscer's script had turning off and on multibox without interacting with HotKeyNet. His whole script only worked if his caps lock was on. Very useful, because if someone messages you in game, you turn caps lock off, reply to him and go back to multibox in seconds. And another thing which is super cool is this part of script. If you have same interface for each character you multibox, and you should have it actually, then when you hold Alt with any mouse clicked, left, right or middle, on that exact position all slaves also click same spell you pressed on Master. Pretty cool, right? You will probably have some minor problems for sure at the beginning, and that's fine. But the more you will play this type of gameplay, the better you will be. It took me several hours to figure this out and more than 1 hour to set up each character. So I will give this one a try. And once I level up all 5 characters to level 70, then I'm sure I'll make more videos about gold making methods using multibox. I hope this tutorial helps you in any way. Thanks for watching. See you again in some other in-game tips video.